I got broads in Atlanta, just the lean in the family, credit cards in the scammers, hitting the licks in the van, legacies, family, wait and see, they like a panda, going out like a...
If 10 people can't make the tackle, and then they get the Grant, and he can't make the tackle, then you got 11 people that you can fuss at, you know what I mean? Just, but if he's a free, watch this, he's on the right hash here, right? He's right here, and it's him reading Jordan Love here from Utah State. Jordan Love is, I hope he gets in the first round somewhere so a good player can fall to us. But, hey, man, just instincts. Grant sees him rolling to the right, then let me go to the right with you. Just small little, because look, if he's rolling, he ain't throwing over there. Some of this is just football common sense, right? But he's going to see these routes develop in front of him. He just see this guy kind of running free almost. Let me give some help over the top. That's going to put me in perfect position to get this interception right here. So I got a theory about Grant's tackling or whatnot. I think when things get off schedule and he kind of got to read and react, I think that's when his tackling is different. Because he tackles guys a little lower. He'll go low and grab some ankles there. But if you take a look at him here, he's on the right hash here. I think when he sees what's in front of him and he got to come down and make a hit, I think he's a better tackler there. He hits harder there. He's never had a problem with willingness, right? He's always willing to tackle. Just as sometimes when you catch him slipping, I will show you a little bit of the technique later. When you catch him slipping, he'll grab angles. But if he could see you the whole way, like such, and then he can come down and lay a hit on you after like reading, you know, quarterback's eyes once again, pass, boom, get the ball out. Then that makes example is him versus like bubble screens, right? He'll see it, boom. If he can see you, wrap up, good form tackle. And I think that's what it is, right? I think if he, it just depends on when it happens. I wanted to show this play so we get a good look of his athleticism. Good look at his athleticism. I saw this play and I'm like, damn, he flying right now. So this was a big run by Auburn. Da 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 da. Running back's gonna get into the open field. Grant Delpit's over here. We just gonna watch Grant just chase this dude down. Grant could have quit, man, but he didn't. LSU they just coached so well. Go get him, Grant. And it was just impressive. We're gonna run it back again. It was impressive to see him cover grass like that. And if he's a free safety, that's gonna be something that we're gonna evaluate him on. We're gonna evaluate him on how much grass he can cover, on the angles that he takes. I think that was a good play to kind of show that. And here's an example of Grant Delpit having to tackle on the fly. This is him entering the box. funny. This is him entering the box. This is the ball has been handed off. And sure, if he's got to make an impromptu tackle, he's going to kind of grab them ankles and get down with you. You know what I mean? Grant is here on the right side of the screen. He's going to come into frame soon. Boom, boom, boom. Yeah, he's going to get down and grab some ankles. You know what I mean? But if he catch you from a distance and he gets to see it the whole way, that's when he really, lays some wood. But besides that, that's what I got on Grant Delpit, man. I didn't want to hold y'all too long. Just wanted to put some things on the screen. Wanted to go over a handful of theories that I had. Stop evaluating him as a strong safety because he ain't a strong safety. He's a free safety. I think he's a damn good free safety. So we'll just cross that road whenever we get there. All right. Where am I drafting him? I'm a Cowboys fan. Cowboy fans asking me, would I take him? Would I take Grant Delpit at 17? I don't know. We'll see.